And I also want to welcome the Prime Minister for having the opportunity of his insights and his work since he left as a Prime Minister and doing very important work on fragile states. But before we get to that, I would be remiss not to acknowledge the President's unceremonious dismissal of his top diplomat this morning via Twitter. This hearing focuses on fragile states and the importance of strong governing institutions that respect the rule of law. And maybe we need to take a look inwards. The foreign policy of the current administration has been marked by chaos, by undermining the very idea of diplomacy, by turning away from those values that have made the United States a vibrant, prosperous democracy driven by the rule of law. We need stable, skilled, seasoned leadership to address the enormous challenges fragile states pose. Regrettably, that's not the kind of leadership I have seen. In fact, we have the opposite, which is placing a severe strain on the international order and accelerates the destabilization of fragile states and regions. While I certainly had my differences with Secretary Tillerson, I cannot see the hollowing out of our State Department and remain silent. I look forward to an opportunity to have a full vetting before the committee, Mr. Chairman, of the designee of the President to be the new Secretary of State, because there is a vast difference between being the CIA Director and being the Secretary of State, and I look forward to that opportunity. Briefly, Mr. Prime Minister, it's an honor to have you before the committee on your perspectives on fragile states and how we develop strategic policies to address fragile states and the failure of states to govern effectively. Broadly speaking, we define states as fragile when their growing institutions are weak, well, I should say their governing institutions are weak. They do not effectively or equally represent, protect, or advocate for all their people and experience high poverty and income inequality. They are less capable of responding effectively to conflict and shocks from natural disaster, and their citizens are often more susceptible to radicalization. Examining instability around the world indicates fragile states are increasingly responsible for the conflict and misery we see in many parts of the globe. So it seems to me that the United States has a vested interest in its own national interests and security, in making investments in how we help build those states from fragile states to strong states with democratic institutions and well-defined governance and rule of law. I will just simply say that when Americans wonder whether or not it is in our national interest to be engaged in fragile states across the globe, I am reminded of the consequences of the interconnectedness that we have in the world, and that what happens someplace else in the world can very often affect us here at home and in our interests abroad. And with that, Mr. Chairman, I ask that the full statement I have be included in the record.
Without objection, thank you. David.